Kaohsiung Gas Explosions. Kaohsiung, the waterfront city and the port of Taiwan. It is a modern and lively city, also known as a highly developed trade and industrial center. On July 31, 2014, the worldwide public familiarized themselves with the city of Kaohsiung for another reason. The entire world got to see the images of a rather unusual accident that turned the town into the scenery of a science fiction movie. The city streets were ripped open as if they were made by a giant space worm. The truth was the damage was caused by a small hole buried in the sewers below the ground. The destruction of more than 4 miles of Kaohsiung streets were caused by a gas leak. The explosion happened in a densely populated area not far from the Kaohsiung City Hall and the area with markets and department stores. The result was damage worth more than $60 million, the death of 32 people, and 321 injured. The rupture in one of the gas pipes that ran under the ground filled the stormwater trench with an enormous amount of propylene gas. Once the gas came in contact with the ignition source, it blew up the street and everything on it in the air. The explosion happened 3 minutes before midnight and was followed by a fire that lasted for 6 more hours. To most residents of the area, the explosion was a shock coming out of nowhere. Many believed an earthquake had happened. Almost no one was aware that an industrial gas pipeline was running just 1 meter below their feet, let alone that it was in dreadful condition and ready to cause a disaster. The industrial gas pipeline that ran along the stormwater system comprised 3 different pipes transporting gas from the Kaohsiung port toward industrial centers. The one that caused the disaster was the smallest, 4 inches in diameter. It transported gas from the China General Terminal and Distribution Corporation, CGTDC, toward the LCY Chemical Corporation plant. The pipeline was built in 1994, 20 years before the accident, when the area was away from the residential part of the city. In 2014, however, the area was densely populated. The presence of the pipeline itself was not a problem, however. Instead, the explosion was caused by improper maintenance of the installation and the negligence of the operators at both ends of the pipeline. On the evening of July 31, 2014, the residents of the Kaohsiung 2nd Road, Kaohsiung 3rd Road, and Ersheng 1st Road in Xianzhen District noticed a cloud of white smoke coming out of several manholes. The firefighters arrived at 20:50 at the scene to inspect the situation. After establishing a command post at the road junction, they secured the area and began spraying manholes with water. The odor clearly pointed to a gas leak, but the firefighters could not determine what type of gas it was, nor the source of the leak. To help with the issue, they called the Environmental Protection Agency's specialist team for toxic substances. The first explosion, a smaller one, happened before the EPA specialists arrived at 2220, more than half a mile away from the firefighters' command post. When the experts from EPA arrived, they started to examine the area where the emission of white smoke was the most intense. They scanned the area with an infrared spectrometer and took the samples of air to examine it. At the same time, operators at the CGTDC port terminal and the LCY plant noticed something wrong was going on. The first to react was the LCY operator, who noticed the zero flow of gas in the factory. At around 2100 hours, he phoned the operator at CGTDC to check if there was a problem. The operator on the other end of the line had a completely different situation. His instrument showed the flow rate of 33,000 kilograms of gas per hour, well above the standard of 23,000 kilograms per hour. However, the pressure in the pipeline dropped from normal 4 to 4.5 megapascals to 2.7 megapascals. The operator at CGTDC immediately switched off the pumps and shut down the valve for security reasons. Both operators agreed to perform a static pressure test that showed no change in pressure while the valves were shut down. The LCY operator, therefore, insisted the gas pumping should be continued. The pumping continued, and the instruments at the CGTDC terminal showed a flow of 24,500 kilograms per hour, but at the LCY plant, it was not more than 7,000 kilograms per hour. The pipeline was losing gas somewhere along the way, but two operators decided to resolve the problem later. At 23:33, a foreman came to his shift at the CGTDC terminal. On his way to a job, he passed along the Kaohsiung 3rd Road and felt a strong smell of gas. He knew the pipeline coming from his terminal was going underneath and suspected something terrible was going on. As soon as he came to work, he reported his concerns to the operator in the control room, who again shut down the pump. It was too late, though. By that time, around 90,000 kilograms of propylene had leaked into a stormwater trench. Then, at 23:57, a massive explosion shook the Xianzhen district. It came with giant fireballs soaring into the sky. The explosion was so powerful that it threw cars from the street to roofs of nearby buildings. The fire trucks, too, were overturned. The explosion blast destroyed all glass surfaces in the vicinity. Hundreds of road pieces flew into the air, causing injuries to bystanders and damaging surrounding buildings. The entire route along the Kaohsiung 2nd, Kaohsiung 3rd Road, and Ersheng 1st Road was destroyed in just a second. The remains of the streets collapsed into a stormwater trench. The explosion attracted the attention of the entire city. Soon, the firefighters from the whole of Kaohsiung and nearby countries arrived at the scene to extinguish the fire and take part in the search and rescue operations. Even the army troops were called for help. The rescuers had a difficult job searching for victims and survivors. They were denied using heavy tools to avoid the possibility of triggering new explosions. Instead, they used life detectors and rescue dogs to locate the people buried under piles of road debris. Once a victim was found, the rescuers would only use bare hands and small tools to dig the way. Victims could be found everywhere, buried in the stormwater trench, on top of buildings and yards away from the explosion site. In hours after the explosion, the ambulance crews could not transport all the injured, so civilian cars and trucks were used for transportation. The injured were taken to 20 different hospitals for treatment. The majority of them suffered burns and cuts. The explosion forced the authorities to order the relocation of the area residents, fearing subsequent explosions might happen. However, people were allowed to return to their homes tomorrow at noon when the area was declared safe. The rescue operation lasted for several days and included 5,567 people. The number of injured reached 321. Unfortunately, the explosion killed 32 people, including two firefighters who were declared dead even though their bodies were never found. The largest and last fire to be extinguished was near the junction between Ersheng 1st Road and Kaohsiung 3rd Road. The firefighters kept it under control until 6 a.m. the following morning when all the gas leaked out. Since this was the most prolonged fire, the inspectors naturally guessed this was the leak's location. Once the air was clear, they examined the trench and found a pipeline leading from the CGTDC terminal to the LCY plant with an opening 4 centimeters by 7 centimeters. It was clear evidence of gas leaking from the pipeline. Investigators also established that the thickness of the pipeline wall was reduced to 1 millimeter from the original 6 millimeters. Years spent in the humid environment of the stormwater trench caused the pipeline to corrode and finally break open. The consequences were obvious. The question arose about how the pipeline system came to be in such poor condition. The finger was pointed at the owner of the pipeline, the LCY Chemical Corporation. The LCY manager shifted the blame to the company that built the pipeline, the government-owned CPC Corporation. Their defense was that the CPC Corp was responsible for maintaining the pipeline they built and that the LCY even had no keys to reach the pipelines. The CPC Corporation answered accusations by claiming they had a contract with LCY only to build the pipeline, not to maintain it. Still, the negligence of the operators at the CGTDC terminal and the LCY plant was apparent. They shut down the pumps only 16 minutes before the explosion, even though it was evident that the gas going out from the terminal wasn't reaching the plant. On August 5th, public prosecutors raided the offices of the CGTDC and the LCY and seized the documents regarding the accident. The investigation ended with the arrest of the CEO and 5 employees of LCY Chemical, 3 employees of CGTDC, and 3 employees of the Kaohsiung Public Works Bureau on charges of negligence to inspect or maintain the pipeline. A lucky circumstance was that the explosion took place around midnight when the traffic was low. Still, many people gathered around the secured area, curious about what was going on. The number of casualties would have been lower if the quality of the road surface in this area had been better. Most of the road surfaces in Kaohsiung were up to 2 meters thick. However, in the area where the explosion took place, it was only 0.5 meters. Such thickness caused the explosion to completely destroy the road and send hundreds of fragments into the air. The reconstruction of the streets, the infrastructure, and the damaged buildings was estimated at 1.9 billion new Taiwanese dollars, equivalent to 68 million US dollars. the public was outraged that the CGTDC and LCY neglected the clear signs of the incoming disaster. They were also angry with the authorities, accusing them of responding too slow once the white smoke appeared. People were also unsatisfied that they had no knowledge the industrial pipeline was running underneath their homes. To answer their petitions, the authorities in Kaohsiung and other cities in Taiwan ordered all infrastructure schemes to be published online. Furthermore, to prevent similar accidents in the future, the authorities also ordered more strict and frequent inspections of the pipeline installations and systems. In addition, an educational program was also started to provide the firefighters with better knowledge of gas-related accidents. Unfortunately, the Kaohsiung gas explosion showed that only when lives are lost, the system begins to pay attention to things they are supposed to be responsible for. I hope you found this video interesting. If you did, please like and subscribe. See you next time.